Get back out to our Baltimore team coverage for when the Colts play the Ravens. Prime time for Monday Night Football. By the way, you can catch every play right here on Wish TV. News 8's Alexis Rogers is live at Baltimore at the Inner Harbor. And just saying that, Alexis, is a big deal, the fact that you're there, because from what I understand, getting there wasn't as easy as you thought it would be.
You know, hey, what's a testimony without a little story, right? It's always that way. But you know what's so amazing about getting a chance to come here? I love culture, and you really get a chance to get a culture of a city when you spend some time, especially in the wee hours of the morning. Right now, we're on the Inner Harbor in the promenade area right near the visitor center. And you can kind of see it behind me. There's the aquarium over here, the museum, the history center is not too far from here. We'll show you in a minute. But over on my right, you can see the entire downtown. There's a lot of history here. And let me tell you, people are friendly too. We've made a couple of friends even early this morning. So my question to you all, do you know what the nickname of Baltimore is?
Home of the Ravens. That's all I got. former home of the Colts.
I got to keep it TV friendly, so I'm just going to say no, I do not.
Okay. Well, you know, Indianapolis is called the Circle City here, and Baltimore, they're called Charm City. Charm City, that's what they're called. It's so funny because you'll actually hear people talk about it, and it's called that way for a couple different reasons. When I spoke with the mayor, he said it's because of the accent and because people are so charmed. That may or may not be the case. Mm-hmm. But when it comes to how they actually got the name, we had to look this up because I wanted to make sure that I had this right. Over the years, you'll hear that phrase, and reports say it goes all the way back to the 1970s. So the waterfront was different back then, not like today. Obviously, we're right off of the water today. A lot of the marketing campaign to try to help talk about the city's hidden treasures was talking about its charm. So it stuck now, and now there's a city skyline, great areas to visit at all times of day, and now people know it as Charm City. Now, I will tell you all this. You know, back in college, I was a tour guide. You know, I walked backwards better than I walked forwards. It was a whole situation. I love learning things like this. Yeah. So, I mean, hey, now you know, put it in your hat that it's Charm City. Have either one of you been to Baltimore?
I have once.
I have not.
It's a beautiful city. That harbor area is awesome. Okay. Where you're at, it's beautiful.
Well, and I'm doing the math here.
And we have a nice breeze, too.
Oh, yeah, that's nice.
I'm thinking, if Marcus and Alexis have been to Charm City and came back so charming, what's going to happen to Phil Sanchez? Right? He's out there with you, right, Alexis?
Well, I think in Phil's mind, he's always charming, okay? Let me tell you. Now I know my lovely co-anchor very, very well.
Look at her sticking by your guns.
A long trip in the car.
What an example.
Yes, yeah. It's a whole situation. But we're going to have more of these fun facts for you all throughout the morning, and we'll get a chance to bring you here with us to Baltimore or Charm City.
Charm City.
Charm City. Lovely. Alexis, charming.
It is charming. It is very, very good.